MotoGP soaks up the unique carnival atmosphere of Termas de Rio Hondo this weekend. A super Saturday in store in South America, and it's time for MotoGP. Brilliant at the moment, a first and second. Aleix Espargaró leads. He's just been joined in the top two by his teammate Maverick Viñales, the top gun at the moment in Argentina, firing on all cylinders. Factory of brilliant team. It's been an incredibly promising Saturday afternoon here in Argentina. Maverick Viñales leads with a 1:38.454. Surely Aleix Espargaró, though, will snatch top spot back. He does indeed. Life in the Argentinian sunshine just gets better and better for the Factory Aprilia team. And this could be a milestone moment in Aleix Espargaró's 200th MotoGP appearance. Is it going to be in Aprilia's first ever MotoGP pole position? It's a 1:37.688. They can't believe it down in Aprilia. Sweet, sweet moments for the Factory Aprilia team.
Yep.
What a way to go into your 200th MotoGP start here tomorrow in Argentina. It was Aleix Espargaró and Aprilia that tangoed here in Argentina. A stunning 1:37.688. Their first ever MotoGP era pole. I think Jeremy McWilliams was the last Aprilia Premier Class pole position.
Yeah.
Phillip Island back in 2000.
He's like, come on, guys, what are you doing? All stopping. Looks like Moto3 qualifying.
Yeah, Pecco Bagnaia, not happy there, was he? It looked like there was a bunch of riders potentially waiting for him, and now he's decided to get his head down. I bet everybody behind him has also decided to go to full gas again. Now, the reason why Bagnaia is getting so frustrated because he's under the pump here. He's got this lap and one other to find a time. He's in 11th place, not inside that top 10. Oh, Bezzecchi's gone down. Yellow flag. His lap will not count. Wow, can you believe it then? Pecco Bagnaia, the pre-season favourite, will not be in Q2.
Wow.
Here again, as that Ducati just ties itself in knots for Pecco Bagnaia yet again. You can clearly see there, Pecco Bagnaia just saying, through turn number 11, I can't do anything.
Yeah, we're going to get a good shot of it. I think he lowers the rear about... Oh, man. The bump's so big it throws the weight on the front, and it, look at it, getting out of shape. He can't hold the throttle steady.
It's just a passenger side at that
yeah.
point, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, oh, Miller's gone down. Oh, Miller in the first corner. And Ducati's, well, the factory Ducati's pretty wretched day here in Argentina just rolls on. Miller had just gone into second place. What about that from Luca Marini? He really dug deep late on there. Great job by Marini. That's why Pablo Nieto is celebrating. A fist pump from the Mooney VR46 racing team boss, because Luca Marini right at the end, and that pushes Mandalika winner Miguel Oliveira into Q1. What late drama here in Argentina. Luca Marini's on the front row of the grid in third place. What a turnaround for him. He only got inside the top 10 late on in FP2. What a job by this man then. Luca Marini on the front row for the first time in Mooney VR46 Ducati colours. So Martin, I was just going to say, this might be close. Jorge Martin absolutely nailed that last sector. His crew are so pumped, and Pramac Ducati, he was as well. Don't celebrate too early yet, Jorge. There's still, what, 70-odd seconds of this session remaining, but he's on pole with a 1:37.839.
I disagree, mate. Celebrate.
Quartararo on a mission here, the world champion. Through turn 14 he comes. Surely this is the best time of the day so far. From the Frenchman it is, a 1:39.216 on lap 24 of the session then for Fabio Quartararo. Nice new shiny brand new Michelin rubber on that Aprilia racing machine as Fabio Quartararo. Speedway style. Well, Fabio Quartararo and Jack Miller exchange a few heated words after the Grand Prix in Mandalika. Last time out, there was a bit of contact between the pair early on in that wet race, and Fabio Quartararo there clearly feels like he was impeded by Miller on that lap.
Well, he was, and Jack would feel terrible. I know he's going to go, oh, no, you know. But, yeah, look at, oh, no.
Yeah, that Ducati was right where Fabio Quartararo wanted to put that Yamaha,
yeah.
wasn't he?
Yeah.
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 Fabio Quartararo has been pushed back down to six. Fabio Quartararo, well, he has to settle for sixth place, and he is going to be angry, not just because of the fact he's on the second row, but he's going to be angry as well with Jack Miller, clearly. Mandalika winner Miguel Oliveira talked about the importance of qualifying. He's got to start from 16th here in Argentina tomorrow. Brad Binder is on a late charge on the factory KTM. What late drama here in Argentina. Aleix Espargaró on course for Aprilia's first MotoGP pole with a 1:37.688, and he's got it. Surely he's got it, yeah. Binder's lost it in the third sector. And this was when Brad Binder was actually on course potentially for pole position, and then it all went wrong, snaking sideways into turn number seven. That's where he lost about a second. At that point, though, as he swept through the fast left-hander turn six, well, the week started positive for Taka Nakagami for all the wrong reasons. It then went negative for all the right reasons. And thankfully, it's back to positive again for all the right reasons here in Termas, on track, doing what he does best. Nakagami leading this FP1 session at 1:39.48. Just going to say, Nakagami was top, 5 minutes ago? He'd actually been pushed back down to 10th, but he's wrestled top spot back on the LCR Honda at 1:39.028. What a week it's been for Taka Nakagami. What a 24 hours. He thought a positive COVID-19 test a couple of days ago was ruling him out of this Termas Grand Prix. Thankfully, he returned a negative test, got himself on a plane down to South America, and he has just topped FP1. What a story, Lewis.
Hola, this is Aleix Espargaró, and if you like this video, hit like, subscribe, and wait for more. Bye!